type vscode in the search bar of your favorite browser, Chrome. Then click this download link. Now click this download button under the one under the Apple. This will start our download for us. Wait for it to download. Then it's a simple installation. Child's play. And I hope it's no surprise for you that I've written a C++ program here in the VS Code after it's done installing. Let's run it. Yeah, that's no surprise either. That's because we don't have the compiler. LOL. We're gonna need to go the underworld and take care of things from there. Press Command plus Spacebar and then type Terminal. Press Enter and we in the darkness now, people. Type exactly what I'm about to. It's the code word to enter the underworld. Clang space hyphen hyphen version. Press Enter and this little dude will pop up. Click Install and yes, of course, we understand the risk. We know there is no turning back on this path. And now we wait for the downloading to finish and then it'll install it automatically. Lean back and get some sleep if you have an internet faster than speed as well, because this is gonna get quite bumpy.
2,000 years later. 1 eternity later.
Now again type clang space hyphen hyphen version. Press enter and we can see now that it says we got our guy. Exit from the terminal and quit it. Go back to VS Code and now let's give it another go. Click this play button. There you go. And if you're wondering that yours haven't got this play button, well, you're right. And it's because you probably don't have this extension called Code Runner. But first, type C in the search bar and install these three extensions. Then type Code Runner and install it and relaunch VS Code. Then go to the settings of Code Runner and make sure that you check these two. Ignore selections and run in terminal. It'll make your lives so much better. Trust me. Then for more customization, you can install this theme called Monarchy 1. I've already got it here. When you've installed it, click this button and then select the theme and your code will look cooler. Hopefully, doing these steps will make it work for you. But if they didn't, follow these steps. Select Terminal from the menu and click Configure Default Build Task. Then select the first and now select the last one. Select the whole thing and delete it. Now go to this link which I've put in the description. Scroll all the way down until you see this block of code. Copy it all and paste it in the tasks.json file. Then save and now run your code again. If it hadn't run before, it should now. That's it for this one. Give the video a thumbs up and subscribe for more, and thanks for watching.